Hello there, and welcome to this video. Let's get a quick overview on the newest Autodesk Maya 2018 and everything you need to know to start using it as a beginner. Please write a comment in the video description and leave us your feedback to improve our next videos on this software. Autodesk Maya is professional software used to realize 3D advanced modeling and outstanding animations. In this video, we will just see the very fundamental features you need when you start for the first time, but you may need additional practice to realize complex modeling and projects. When you open Maya, its workspace opens on a new empty project, showing several bars and palettes around the main preview of your project. All the main drawing and editing tools are collected on top, divided in several tabs. Let's see the main 2D and 3D drawing tools to drop objects on your workspace. Under the Curved Surfaces tab, you have all the tools to draw 2D objects, or NURBS, inside Maya, divided in 2D curves on the left and 2D surfaces on the right. You can hover over each tool to get additional information on it. To draw regular curves, you can use NURBS Circle and NURBS Square to drop circles or squares right on the center of your workspace. All the other tools allow you to create customized curves. Choose 3-point circular arc to draw an arc by fixing 3 points on your workspace. Choose EP Curve tool to draw a completely customized curve by fixing continuous points on your workspace. To stop drawing, right-click on your workspace and drag your pointer to Complete tool. To draw freehand, you can use the Pencil Curve tool and click and drag the curve as you like. While drawing, you can use snappings to get help if you need. At the very top, you can enable and disable snappings to either the 2D grid, any curve path, or any object point. Check them out. When you draw an object, this is dropped when the last point required is fixed. If you want to get a preview of the object in progress before it is applied, you can hold on your click and drag it. When you release the click, the point is fixed, and so is the object. Whereas, if you make a mistake and want to undo the whole drawing, just use the Escape key. Besides the drawing tools, you also have several editing tools dedicated to curves. Make sure to click on the curve with the Select tool to select it, and then use the editing tools to extend it, edit their sides, or add more points to it. If you make any mistake, use Ctrl and Z to undo your latest actions. All these 2D curves lay on the ground plane, indicated by the 2D grid you see, and identified by the X and the Z axes, as you can see from the Cartesian system in the bottom left corner. Inside the Curved Surfaces tab, you also have the NURBS surfaces, which are 2D objects with no volume. In respect to curves, these spread on all the three main directions, such as the X and the Z axes, but also the Y axis, which represents the height from the ground. As seen for the curves, you can choose to use ready templates to drop a sphere, a cube, a cylinder, a cone, a plane, or a torus surface, all dropped at the center of your project. Or choose to create customized surfaces starting from existing curves. For example, the Revolve tool creates a surface by revolving a curve around either its center or the center of your workspace. The Planar tool creates a surface by selecting a 2D closed curve that forms a boundary. The Extrude tool is used to create more complex surfaces by selecting two curves. With the Select tool enabled, hold Shift down and select a first curve to use as a section, and a second curve to define the direction and the extrusion length. When you click on the Extrude tool, the surface is rendered. The result can also depend on the correct order you have selected for the two curves. Consider that the surface may change shape if you edit any of the two original curves. Just like the curves, there are several editing tools dedicated to surfaces on top. Check them out. To drop 3D objects with volume, you have to switch to the Poly Modeling tab. Here, you can choose to drop regular polygons on the center of your workspace, such as 3D spheres, cubes, cylinders, cones, and tori. You can also drop regular polygons, such as pyramids and prisms, with the Platonic Solid tool, new in Maya 2018. Check it out! Moreover, with the Polygon Type tool, you can drop a 3D text on your project that you can edit through the Attribute Editor panel that opens on the right. Next to the drawing tools, you have all the editing tools for 3D polygons. For example, if you select the object and click on Bevel Components, you will add bevels on your polygon and regulate these through the Attribute Editor. If you don't have it open, just use the third button in the top right corner. If these 3D polygon tools are not enough, you can switch to the Sculpting tab, which lists several advanced tools to model your objects by clicking and brushing on it directly. To regulate the options for these tools, such as brush size and hardness, you can open the Tool Settings panel from the fourth button in the top right corner. If these tools don't work fine, you may need to adjust the smoothness level of the object, which means increasing the number of its edges and faces. Switch to the Poly Modeling tab, select the polygon, and enable the Smooth tool as many times as you need. At this point, any tool from the Sculpting tab will be more effective. To check your project, use your mouse wheel to zoom in and out, or hold Alt down and click and drag to change the point of view. You can also pan and move by holding Alt down and clicking and holding your mouse wheel. To edit an object, you have to select it first. If you select multiple objects and apply a tool, all these will be edited in the same way. So it is important to make proper selections by using the tools on the extreme left. With the Select tool, you can select single objects or more of them by holding Shift down and clicking on each of them, or by creating a rectangular area by clicking and dragging to select all objects that touch it. To deselect, just click elsewhere. Now let's see other great features to edit your objects. To cut, copy, and paste selected objects, just use Ctrl and X, Ctrl and C, and Ctrl and V. To transform your object and shape an appearance, you have to use the Modeling Toolkit panel and the editing tools on the extreme left of your workspace. Here you can use the Move, the Rotate, and the Scale tool to move, rotate, and scale the selected object in respect to the three main Cartesian axes as shown on the object. The x-axis is red, the z-axis in blue, and the y-axis in green color. Once you have chosen either the Move, the Rotate, or the Scale tool, go to the Modeling Toolkit panel on the right and select Tweak Marquee from the list on top. If you miss this panel, you can open it by using the first button on top. Once done, you can click and drag on the object to move, rotate, and scale it freely in respect to your point of view. Whereas, if you want to move, rotate, and scale along one or two axis directions, just go to the bottom side of the Modeling Toolkit, enable the axes interested, and type the value you are applying with the Enter key. In addition, the Modeling Toolkit can be used to edit and shape your curves, surfaces, and polygons by working on each of their subcomponents, such as its vertices, edges, and faces. In fact, if you select these and then move, rotate, and scale them, you will also edit the overall object shape as you like. You can work with vertices, edges, and faces depending on what you choose on top. By default, object selection is enabled, which allows you to work within the whole object as it is. If you choose vertex selection, you will select and edit each object vertex. If you enable edge selection, you will work with edges. And if you use face selection, you will work with object faces. After choosing the correct selection mode, you have to select the proper vertices, edges, or faces you want to edit. You can use the Select tool, as seen previously, or use the Paint Selection tool, which is very useful in this case, since it selects all the subcomponents you brush on. You can also remove some of your selection by holding Ctrl down and brushing. To adjust the brush radius and settings, remember to use the Tool Settings panel. Once the project subcomponents are selected, go on editing the object shape by moving, rotating, and scaling. Maya is one of the best pieces of software to realize animations. At the bottom of the workspace, you have the main timeline, which represents, for each selected object, all the animations applied on it through several markers called keyframes. Keyframes are special markers placed in fixed instances of time that save a particular set of object properties, such as size, position, shape, and even effects, so that if two keyframes are placed in two different instances of time, saving a different set of object properties, an animation is created where the object changes in time from the first keyframe to the second. In this way, keyframe after keyframe, you can make the object move or get it modified as you like. Let's see how to do this. Select the object to animate, and then fix the frame where to place the first keyframe by clicking and dragging on the timeline below. Press the S key, and a new keyframe will be created, represented as a red marker. Then, fix the second instant of time, and edit the project for how it should look after the animation. If you have auto keyframe toggle on, the second keyframe is automatically created when you edit the object. When you play back the animation, you will see your object changing from the first to the second keyframe. The animation duration depends on the number of frames between such keyframes. The more there are, the slower the transition will be. You can play back animations by clicking and dragging on the timeline, or by using the player on the extreme right. If you need to delete a keyframe, just select its frame, right-click, and go to Delete. The timeline measures time in frames that are converted in seconds depending on the frame rate you choose. If you go to Animation Preferences and then to Time Slider, you can select the correct frame rate under Frame Rate. Moreover, the timeline is made by 200 frames in total by default. You can extend it by typing the total number of frames you like on the second slot on the right. Keyframes can act on the whole object, but also on its own subcomponents. For example, you can apply animations to subcomponents in order to change the object shape in time. Once your project is done, you can save it by going to File, and then to Save Scene As. Maya project files are saved in a .mb file format, and are very useful to open and retrieve your project later, in order to add new modifications on it if you need. Thank you for watching this video. Check out our channel for more amazing and outstanding free video guides.